Welcome to the ZEISS Microscopy Customer Center in Oberkochen. It's great to have you here with us today. So we've got new confocal systems coming up, and with these we have a completely new technology. And my colleague Tara just arrived from our ZEISS Microscopy headquarters in Jena to tell us more about that. Welcome, Tara.
Thanks, Miriam. I'm happy to be here. Here at the Customer Center, you spend a lot of your time sharing with scientists and microscopists the various systems that we have in our ZEISS portfolio, right?
Exactly. So we have all the different systems here, so it's the perfect place to test and find solutions for different applications. So for example, something we see more and more coming up now is live imaging.
Which live cell imaging is amazing, but also comes with a lot of its own challenges sometimes, right?
Yes, absolutely right. So it gets especially challenging when users come with samples that require very fast imaging of large 3D volumes. So this can be, for example, living organisms or a process inside of a living organism or also neuronal activity. And to even attempt this, we usually have to cut down on spatial resolution and reduce the volume quite a bit. And then it gets really frustrating because we don't even know which information we are missing.
Yeah, I know just what you mean. And this is a really common problem that we have, right, with imaging live biological samples. Yeah. I think this is really well illustrated with a wave pendulum, which we can think of as a biological system in this scenario. And for example, one thing we're really good at already with existing technology is imaging at a single position very quickly. But as soon as you want to start moving through an entire volume and taking a Z-stack, which is how we usually accomplish this, then as we get to later points in the Z-stack, we are no longer capturing the information that's happening in the earlier part of the Z-stack, and that can change over time, right? And so then we're not getting the whole picture.
To understand the fast process in 3D, you would actually have to capture the whole volume at once.
Exactly. And what's great is that we now have a new technology that we're adding to our confocal systems called Lightfield 4D that's solving this exact problem. We are able to capture entire volumes in a single snap without any time delay between positions.
So that means we really capture every single pixel in a Z stack at exactly the same time.
Yep, exactly. This is the idea. I think now would be a good time for us to look at some examples. So here we have plant ovules and pollen tubules coming in. And this entire 3D volume was captured with Lightfield 4D in a single instant. So it really enables us to capture multicolor Z-stacks without having to move the sample or the focal plane at all.
Okay, that's crazy.
It really is. This is really going to bring our 3D volume imaging and the imaging of 3D movement to the next level. A great example of this is with the zebrafish heartbeat. In the past, scientists had to understand the zebrafish heartbeat from the perspective of taking 2D movies at different positions throughout the entire 3D volume and then aligning and averaging these. But now, with Lightfield 4D, we can actually generate a real 3D movie of the zebrafish heartbeat and see how each individual cell moves in time and space.
That makes such a difference.
Such a difference.
So can you tell us a bit about how we do this? I mean, how are we able to capture such a large volume instantaneously? I mean, we did not beat physics or speed of light, did we?
No, not yet. So we're doing this by using light field technology. And this enables volume capture in a single instant. And this is accomplished by using a multi-lens array. So we have an array of 37 different lenses we can see here. And this enables images captured at 37 different angles of the same sample. And this then projects 37 different images onto the camera. And with all of this different angular information, we're able to reconstruct 3D spatial information of the sample.
So now we have these 37 images from different perspectives, but how do we get an actual data set out of that that we can use then?
That's a great question. So of course you can keep all this raw data of these 37 different images, but this really gets turned into a 3D volume by this deconvolution-based processing step that then gives you a Z-stack, just like what you're used to getting from an LSM system.
Amazing. So this really gives us a complete Z-stack in a snap, in an instant.
Yep. and nothing is as fast as instantaneous.
So it's really one snap, one volume. This means it's perfect for dynamic processes in living specimen. So we can follow dynamics in a large volume with much higher temporal resolution than ever before.
Yeah, exactly. So I think a great example that really illustrates this point comes from a sample from one of the scientists during our beta testing. Here it's from a Drosophila, and this is during the stage of pre-pupa, so it's in between Drosophila larva and pupa before they become adult. And here we can see the hemocytes, which are the insect blood cells, circulating throughout the abdomen. And you, Miriam, actually helped us with a ton of image analysis for these data sample sets. So maybe you could explain a little bit about the image analysis here.
Yes, sure. So light field for the data is nearly isometric, and that makes it incredibly straightforward to analyze with the 3D algorithms from Aurelius. So for example, here, I first segmented the cells and then tracked their movement with the automated algorithm over time. So that means we can really analyze these kind of processes and get proper data out of this. Another example is if we go back to the zebrafish heartbeat here. So you can see that also here, we segmented the heart muscle nuclei and then tracked their movement over time. So you can really analyze this movement. And now with the speed we have here, you can also see irregular heartbeats or even more rare events.
Yeah, I think with this technology, we'll really be able to image 3D movement of things at a much higher rate than we've ever been able to do for many different samples, where maybe we couldn't ever collect data from those samples before. So another example that I really like of this, where analyzing the data wasn't even possible before, is this example also from our beta testing with an Arabidopsis plant stem. And here you can see there's green fluorescent protein localized to the boundaries of these cells in the stem. And upon blue light stimulation, these green protein coalesces and internalizes and then generates these particles that tracking in 3D wasn't possible before because we just didn't have the speed to capture the volume. But now with Lightfield 4D, it is. And what's cool is that this instantaneous volume acquisition is also really gentle for imaging live samples. And so here we can see an example with the Drosophila gut development. And we took an image every 10 seconds for 5 hours straight for this sample, and we didn't see any evidence of phototoxicity.
This is almost too good to be true. So this means we can really use the fast volume acquisition without harming the sample at the same time.
Yep, and we can also take advantage of this fast acquisition speed to increase your throughput by imaging many different positions, multiple samples during the same time-lapse experiment. So here's another really good example of that from our beta tests, where we can see these are cells that are going to be forming in Drosophila adults. The structure is known as the fat body, and we can see them migrating in to form this structure. But this is just one of the pre-pupa, again, that we imaged out of 10 different animals that we were imaging at the same time.
So you image 10 different positions in one single experiment. That definitely increases your chance of getting useful data out of this, right? Of seeing rare events. And it also means you're imaging all samples at exactly the same conditions.
Yep, there are a lot of aspects of this that are really great for sample acquisition. So when we were doing our beta tests, we actually ended up increasing the rate of the image acquisition and the number of samples that we were acquiring in a time lapse compared to what the scientists were actually asking for, just because they weren't used to working with these kinds of speeds. So here's another example with the zebrafish ear development, where we surprised the scientist by actually collecting multiple different sets of this ear development during the same overnight time-lapse experiment.
And even with the increased temporal resolution and many more images acquired, we did not see any phototoxic effect on ear development. And that's a process that is quite sensitive to phototoxicity. So this is really impressive. And honestly, even if the sample is fixed and labeled like organoids or spheroids, the increase in imaging speed means faster data acquisition, speeding up the science.
For sure. Here's an example of a single liver cell spheroid that was part of a huge field of spheroids and brings to mind how one could use this kind of imaging speed to do some pretty high throughput screening experiments. Here's another example with a really large 3D spheroid, multicolor. And this one was fixed and cleared and only took a couple of seconds to image rather than minutes, which is what we're used to. And so you can imagine how fast one might be able to image a multi-well plate, for example, using Lightfield 4D.
And this means we get to the analysis step much quicker, like in this example, the cell counting. And in the end, you gain time for more experiments. So let's talk about what we can do if we need more information from our sample, like a higher resolution, spectral information, or even molecular dynamics.
Yeah, so that's what's really great about Lightfield 4D being a part of the entire LSM system, is that you can combine Lightfield data acquisition with the other modalities that the LSM system has to offer. One really nice example of this is this recording of neuronal activity here in the zebrafish brain. So many cells in many different positions throughout the brain volume are firing, sometimes at the exact same time. But now that we have the complete volume acquired in one shot, we no longer miss these events that are happening simultaneously.
And after the dynamics are recorded, we can then switch to area scan multiplex mode and record a high resolution C-stack of the brain, giving us much better morphological information, right?
Yep. And again, we can transition between these modes without having to move the sample or even changing the objective lens.
So this really adds a completely new mode to the LSM, allowing us to do multimodal and multi-scale imaging without having to change sample preparation.
Yep. Another great example of this is with some higher resolution images of some neurons here that we imaged both with Lightfield 4D and with ARRI scan. And these together really show how integrated the Lightfield 4D technology is with the existing LSM system, and how it will be quite easy, honestly, to use and train and incorporate in with other LSM modalities.
This is really cool, and I cannot wait for our guests to come and try it for themselves. So if you would like to learn more about the new LSMs with Lightfield 4D, please visit our website, and we are looking forward to answering your questions.
We are really so excited to see how you all utilize this new technology and what great new discoveries are made using Lightfield 4D.
And I totally forgot what I'm going to say now.
Speeding up the science, man.
Yeah. Multi-scale and multi-whatever imaging. So this is really impressive.
I'm so sorry. So we have our brain slice sample on now?
Yep.
Perfect. Okay. So you can go ahead and take a snap.
All right.
Take a look.
I take a snap. So now it's acquiring the set stick, right?
No, it already did.
Ah, okay.
Did you blink? Did you
miss it? That was it, basically. Yeah. That's the volume already.
Yeah, yeah.
Ah, cool. Okay, and so how about processing now?
Yep. So we can just click Lightfield 4D
mm-hmm.
here.
Yep. Lightfield 4D.
We'll have different processing options.
Yes.
We'll just take the defaults for now. We have this preview here, but go ahead and click processed image.
All right. So now I guess we can go for coffee, right? While it's processing.
It's already done.
It's already done?
Yep.
Wow. So fast.
No more free coffee breaks for you.
Okay. All right. That's really great. So it's so fast to just get a volume like this, right? It's really just a snap. Looks really good. You can see all the projections of the neurons. Beautiful.
When life unveils its secret, you won't miss it. Following the heartbeat of life. ZEISS LSM with Lightfield 4D. In motion, in depth. How many volumes is a breakthrough? Introducing instant volume imaging at speed. One snap, one volume. 80 volumes per second. Instant volume, instant insight. ZEISS LSM with Lightfield 4D. Dynamics of life discovered by you. Join us when life reveals its secrets.